And now back to your regularly scheduled program.
Welcome back to the channel, everybody. My name's Artie with CoinCasso, and this is Bitcoin Today, a show where we discuss everything cryptocurrency to keep you guys up to date and informed on all things happening in the crypto industry. In today's video, I want to discuss Bitcoin's nearly 25% rally over the last few weeks. We're gonna do a deep dive technical analysis to see where the price action is going to go in the near and short term future, as well as taking a look at Ethereum to see if it can catch up to the momentum that Bitcoin has. And just like always, we go over the top cryptocurrency prices as well as the top movers in the last 24 hours. Good morning, everybody. It is Monday, October 26th. Thank you so much for joining me every single day. Thank you so much for joining me on the live streams that we did all last week. The turnout and the response from you guys was absolutely incredible. We had huge channel growth, nearly 500 subscribers all over last week. And if you're new here and you like what you see in this video, don't forget to subscribe down below and tick the notification bell to get notified every time we upload a new one. And if you guys weren't a part of all of the live streams that we did last week, we were doing 60-second Bitcoin binary options. I'm gonna show you really quick what we were doing, and then I'm gonna continue on with the normal video. Basically, you register for free for a free account on the CoinCasso exchange. On the left-hand side here, down on the app section, you click apps, you are taken to a page where we have all of our apps, and we were playing a game called Long Short. So basically it works like this. You have a hotkey for 1 USDT, 10 USDT, and 100 USDT, and basically you have to guess if the price is going to be higher or lower in 60 seconds. So just to show you guys really quick, let's go long on this position. And you get a timer for 60 seconds, and if in that 60 seconds you're winning, it's flashing green. If you're losing, it's flashing red. And boom, you get a confetti cannon if you win, you get 80% profits. So I bet 10 USDT, I got 18 USDT back, which means my profits are 8 USDT in 60 seconds. And if you use good technical analysis on a really, really small time frame, the likelihood of you winning more than losing is really good. And that's the game Long Short in a nutshell. So let's get back to the normal video. All right, let's get into these cryptocurrency prices. Jumping onto the CoinCasso homepage, Bitcoin currently sitting at $13,099.54, up nearly 1% from yesterday. Ethereum sitting at $406.42, nearly flat from yesterday. And Chainlink doing really well lately, $12.24, but it's actually down 0.5% from yesterday. All right, welcome back to the regularly scheduled programming where we go over all cryptocurrency news as well as do technical analysis on the top moving cryptocurrencies. The last time I did one of these videos was October 16th, and at that point, Bitcoin was sitting at about $10,811,000. And now we are above $13,000, which I didn't think was going to happen this soon. But the news of PayPal offering crypto services to all of its users just made everything explode. So let's do some technical analysis and look at the charts. Jumping onto the CoinCasso cryptocurrency exchange, right here we have Bitcoin and the chart brought to you by TradingView. Let's zoom this bad boy out. And now we are looking at the price of Bitcoin on the 1 hour candlestick chart. And I want to bring this back to the beginning of October. On October 1st, Bitcoin was sitting at about $10,538. And with its peak here at $13,374, that represents a gain of 23%. And if you guys remember the humongous drop that we had on September 1st, right here, the price was at $12,000 and dropped all the way down to $9,800. Since then, we have shot back and blown past that $12,000 and $12,500 barrier with a lot of force. And we're at a price right now that Bitcoin has not seen since 2018. Okay, so I want to show you guys one thing. If you've gone through my little training course that I have linked in the description below, it's like 20 minutes of me talking about moving averages and Fibonacci retracements. Okay, we have to look at this price action from the very beginning when Bitcoin was sitting in the hundreds of dollars. We're going to take the Fibonacci tool. We're going to draw it at the lowest point that we can see here, all the way up to the highest point, and the body of that candlestick was right about there. You can see as the price came down, it rejected at the 618 level, shot back up, and then it rejected back down. We had massive selling off of Bitcoin at this time. Basically, it was just too early in the cryptocurrency space for this to maintain its momentum upwards, and it just straight rejected downwards. So let's get rid of that and take it from the highest point to the lowest point here. You can see as the price came back, it rejected again at the 618 level, making a perfect short sell scenario. I mean, 618 rejection, short that thing. And the price came all the way down to $3,970 before it climbed all the way back up here to $13,000. Now, one thing I want to caution everyone on with Bitcoin, if it rejects here at this 618 level, it is going to come back down, and it's going to come back down hard. But that's only looking at the long-term trend, and I don't think those statistics are relevant anymore with cryptocurrencies and how big financial institutions and companies like PayPal are now in the mix. So we're going to have to look at short-term movement here. Since the bottom on March 12th, we are actually still on an uptrend. This last big move that we had here up to the $12,500 level will take it from the bottom and bring it up to the top. You can see here again a rejection of the 618. Let me zoom it in a little bit closer so you guys can see exactly. Price came down and actually touched the 764, rejected, came back up, and it's now dancing in between all of these Fibonacci levels. It blew through this one right here, and that's because of the news. But now we're hitting this level and showing some rejection. So if it does come back down, it's going to come back down to 12,469. And then continue its momentum up. The other scenario is taking it from this last bull run here that we had since October 8th up to the top right here. And if it does reject here and start coming back down, it should reject at the 0.5 or the 618, which is 11,500 and 11,800. So don't be surprised if it comes down here. Don't panic, do not sell off at this point, because at this level, it should reject and continue its upward momentum. If it goes past it, then we're looking at the long-term Fibonacci retracement of that $20,000 level, and then you should be extremely worried. But again, I really don't think the likelihood of that happening. Basically, the probability is low. Now, I want to take a look at Ethereum because it has not caught up to the price action of Bitcoin. I know they're two separate things, but cryptocurrencies, usually the top two will move in sync. So here at our highest price, we hit what? $489 and drop down to a low of $309. If you take a Fibonacci tool and take it from the bottom here of this bull run up to the top, you're seeing a perfect 618 retracement. So this should continue on the upside, moving higher than its peak on September 1st, just like Bitcoin did. The one thing I was really concerned with is if you were to take this and think about it as a bearish momentum, meaning downwards, and take it from the top here to the lowest point, we're rejecting here at the 618. I don't think it will drop below 398. If it does, maybe 380, but I don't think it'll go any lower than that, and then continue upwards. This is an area I was really concerned about, but with Bitcoin being above its highest price, I really don't think that this is a solid rejection on the downside. So if you guys still haven't gotten back into Bitcoin, Ethereum, Chainlink, look for a rejection on a 618 level for your entry point. By that, I mean take the latest bull run that we've had from 368 all the way up to 413, and if this price keeps going down, it will reject here at 386. That's going to be your entry point. Basically, all the news all across the board on all cryptocurrencies is very, very positive right now. We had huge bullish momentum from the news of PayPal, lots of liquidity back in the market, and consumer confidence is way up. It's still not to the point of euphoria where everybody's saying that Bitcoin's going to rally to $300,000, but that's a good thing. Right now, the momentum will keep going upwards, and until we get to that euphoric stage where you hear everybody talking about Bitcoin, that it is made of gold, you should invest all of your money and just get 100% behind cryptocurrencies. At that point, usually the big boys short the market and it just dumps down. So if you hear Aunt Sally talking about Bitcoin, you know it's probably a good time to get out. Always buy the dip. Buy low, sell high. Buy when everybody's pessimistic and afraid of cryptocurrencies, and sell when everybody is on cloud nine and making money. Okay, now you guys know what time it is. Let's choose the fan of the day. If you guys don't know what fan of the day is, I pick a random comment using a random comment generator from my previous video. That person is dubbed fan of the day, pinned comment on that video, and winner of 10 USDT. So jumping into my last video talking about Bitcoin and Ethereum, that it's time to buy Ethereum, which you should have done at that time because you'd be up like 20% by now, and search. And the winner of fan of the day is Heartland Oki. His comment was, "You rock, seriously, like metalhead bang your head type rock, love your channel." That is a really nice comment and a great way to start a Monday. Congratulations, you are now fan of the day. You will be the pinned comment. Make sure you're signed up to the CoinCasso exchange. Type in your ID number in the comment thread of that comment and I will send you 10 USDT. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and remember, do not forget to leave a like and comment on your way out and subscribe to the channel. Thank you guys so much, and I will see you back here tomorrow.